हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द पोएम ऑन रिसीट ऑफ माय मदर्स पिक्चर बाय विलियम कोपर। विलियम कोपर, ही बॉर्न इन 26 नवंबर 1731 एंड ही डाइड इन 25 अप्रैल 1800। ही वॉज द पोएट हु चेंज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ 18th सेंचुरी नेचर पोएट्री बाय राइटिंग ऑफ एवरी डे लाइफ एंड सीन ऑफ एवरी English countryside. Means in his writing we can notice the theme of everyday life and countryside. Countryside means rural area, rural life. That's why William Cowper is called the forerunner of romantic poetry, because in romantic poetry also we see the thoughts of nature, love for nature, love for simple language, love for humanity. And in this poem also we can observe the thoughts and feelings that aroused by the picture of his mother's side. When this poet, he gets the picture of his mother, actually what happens when the poet was only 16-year-old child, he lost his mother. Suddenly what happens, now he is 60 year old, so he became old now. Suddenly he receives the portrait of his mother from his cousin, and all the memories comes into his mind. He recollects the memories of his childhood. So in the first stanza of the poem, "Oh, that those lips had language, life had passed with me but roughly since I heard the last. Those lips are thine, thy own sweet smile I see, the same that often in child solaced me. Voice only fails as how distinct they say, grieve not my child, chase all thy fears away. The meek intelligence of those dear eyes bless me the art that can immortalize, the art that baffles time's tyrannic claim, to quench it here shines on me still the same." So in the first line of the poem, the poet is saying those lips had language, means he is looking at the portrait of his mother's picture and he is saying that still it seems that these lips had language. Like picture is trying to say something to his son, mother trying to say something to his son, that life has been quite hard to him, that life was very hard after mother's death. He had heard the last word when poet was very small child. He was only 6th year old, and he heard the last words from his mother. Those lips were sweet with smiles, and these lips were very sweet because her mother always used to smile. Smile was always on the face of, on the lips of her mother, and this smile used to give her and this smile used to give him comfort. Comfort means solace. Now the picture has no voice because mother is no more there, but picture is consoling the poet that grieve me, grieve not, means don't feel sad. Picture is telling him not to grieve. Poet can hear the words from the picture that somewhere his mother is telling him that although I am not there, I am no more, but still life is there. Grieve not my child, chase all thy fears away. All your fears away. Remove your fears. The meek intelligence of those eyes, ही इज कॉलिंग द मीक इंटेलिजेंसी टू द पिक्चर्स. पिक्चर शोज वेरी क्लियर ब्रिलियंट आईज, दैट इज हिज मदर्स आईज. आईज ऑफ हिज मदर सीम्स टू बी वेरी शावरिंग. फेथफुल रिमेम्बरेंस ऑफ वन सो डियर, ओ वेलकम गेस्ट दो अनएक्सपेक्टेड हियर, हु विडस्ट मी ऑनर विद एन आर्टलेस सॉन्ग, अफेक्शनेट ए मदर लॉस्ट सो लॉन्ग. I will obey not willingly alone but gladly as the precept were her own, and while that face renews my filial grief, fancy shall weave a charm for my relief, shall steep me in elysian reverie, a memory dream that thou art she. Now he is saying that you are like a remembrance. Remembrance means just memory for me, because I lost you long back when I was only a child, and now this picture is for me like a welcome guest who comes suddenly, unexpectedly. So you are like a guest for me, unexpected guest who bids me honor, who provides me honor with an artless song. Artless song means portrait, that is a part of an art. Affectionate was the mother for him. A mother lost so long, who used to give me affection, whom I lost so long. I will obey, not willingly alone, but gladly. Means mother, I will obey you, that you are saying me you should not grieve for my death, so I will obey you not willingly alone but gladly, but happily, as the precept were her own. And while that face renews my filial grief, and your face renews my grief also, because whenever I saw your picture it provides me grief also, it gives me somewhere my old memories, when I used to play with you, when I used to laugh with you, when you used to give me affection, but you are no more there. But still I am happy and I am with grief. Fancy shall weave a charm for my relief. But fancy means your memories. This will give me a charm. Charm means and preserved beauty of the eyes, which he will remember. And for him, this painting is mortal, because art is immortal, and this painting will make you mortal, because painter has made this mother immortal. So it will be very charming that he will always revive his mother's memories again and again. So I think this is enough for today. We will discuss the stanza third and fourth later. Okay, thank you.